This is the Grafton State Hospital Cemetery in Grafton, Massachusetts. Here in this picture, you can see a massive stonewater tower that identifies the location in which is the Grafton State Hospital Cemetery. This is the inside of the water tower located at the Grafton State Hospital Cemetery. Here you can see the top of the tower, which is located at the Grafton State Hospital Cemetery. Here you can see in a memorial that has been made for those who have fought in the armed forces. Some of them are listed with numbers, and the other numbers that are not listed on there that are located in the cemetery are from those who have been patients of the Grafton State Hospital. So both the armed forces and state hospital patients have been buried in this cemetery. Here is a closer look at the memorial. As you can see, there are numbers listed on here with names and the date of birth and the death of the people that have fought in the armed forces. These people are located in the cemetery, also with the patients of the hospital. Here is one of the numbers from one of the patients or from one of the people from the armed forces. Here is another number that is from the armed forces or the patients. I found quite a few of these, a lot in the hundreds, but not all of these in the hundreds have been listed as armed forces. Some of these are also patients. 1,041 patients of the former Grafton State Hospital, 14 of them veterans, were buried here. All were unclaimed by relatives. A white obelisk in the center is joined to a bronze marker listing the veterans' names and grave numbers. They are now also identified by a United States flag marker. Graves are marked with a 6x12 inch granite marker. Only a few of those buried within have actual names and dates. Here is the Tonella Restaurant, Shrewsbury, Massachusetts. For a number of years, during the mid-1970s, the Tonella Restaurant was a fairly popular location for local people to get some Polynesian cuisine. The Tonella was known for its large tiki statue and Polynesian-themed decor on the outside of the building. The business also added several motel-like apartments at the rear of the property, but soon fell on hard times, the restaurant closing down, but the motel units remaining in operation. During the early 2000s, an attempt was made to revive the business, being home to a heavy metal-type venue called Trans Buddha. That didn't work out either and soon closed. Within a few more years, the apartments were closed. The building, along with the large tiki statue, remained intact at the Route 20 location, although overall the site and the ground continued to deteriorate. Here you can see several motel-like apartments at the rear of the property. Here is a picture of the back of the building. As you can see, the building has many trees that have overgrown. Also, you can see that there has been an abandoned chair left outside with a tire and a small little table. Here is a closer look at those three things that I mentioned: the abandoned chair, the tire, and the table with a bunch of overgrown grass and trees. If you look closely, you can see the tiki statue. His mouth is covered with grass, but you can at least see the top of his nose and his two eyes and the top of his head. What a great piece of history. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Please like and leave a comment below, and also make sure that you click on the bell so that you can get updates on my next video.